Hello guys and welcome back. In this video I will share with you a very useful mod for Cyberpunk 2077. And I decided to do a voiceover today to explain everything. And sorry in advance if I sound confused or anything, because this is the first time I do these kind of videos. So without further ado, let's get started. As you know, Cyberpunk 2077 released last week, and technically it was a mess on PC and especially on consoles. And playing the game with low-end or even mid-range GPU with stable FPS is so hard, but with this mod we can gain access to hidden graphics settings and squeeze more FPS from the game. So let's jump to my PC and I will show you how to install and use this mod. So as you can see here, this is the page of the mod on nexusmods.com. The mod called Config Overall for Cyberpunk 2077. Of course, you can download this mod by going to files, like here, manual download, and then you click on slow download. You wait a little bit, and then you can download it. After that, you go to the mod, you extract it, and then you copy the exe like this, and you paste it to where the game is installed. For me it's here. You paste the mod here, not inside the x64 folder. You paste the mod on the root folder like this, and then you can open it like this. As you can see here, there is a lot of graphics and configuration stuff that you can disable or enable as you want. So to test this mod, I will start the game without it to let you see how much FPS I can gain using this mod. So I reset everything so nothing is changed, as you can see here, and then I will start the game from here. I will speed up the video a little bit so we don't have to wait. So as you can see here, this is the graphics of the game. I'm running the game right now on medium texture here, and on low, everything on low, as you can see here, with the 87 resolution scaling option. And the resolution scaling option I'm using 87%. So let's start the game. I'm gonna use this save. So as you can see here, without the mod, I'm getting like 30 to 34, 35 FPS at this particular place right here. So it's 35, 36, 39 FPS. The maximum FPS I saw was like 39, and of course the game drops below 30 FPS in some instances. So let's stop right here and let's use the mod and see how much FPS we can gain and what kind of sacrifice in the visual this mod do to the game. So right now I'm gonna use the mod. Always run the mod as administrator. And the first thing you need to do is disable instant compute, and do this only if you have an old GPU. As the description said here, should help GeForce GPUs and also older pre-Vega AMD Radeon. So if you have a pre RTX 20 series GPU, like 10 series or 16 series, or like a 900 series, 700 series, of course, or if you have an RX 570 or an RX 580, or if you have a 480, 470, do this. Don't do this if you have a GPU like RTX 20 series or an AMD Vega. And after that, you can of course disable or enable anything you want from here, but I will use the preset here and I will use low. In my opinion, low give me the best visual and the best performance on the GTX 1050 Ti here. Do this, you can of course test different preset here, you can test different configuration, and you can see what kind of performance you will gain, and you can decide the best for your GPU and of course CPU. So let's use low here and let's see how much FPS we will gain. So as you can see here guys, same setting, medium texture, everything on low, nothing changed. Resolution scaling is 87. Something I didn't mention before, I'm using low crowd density because my CPU is really bad, and I'm using slow HDD mode because I'm running the game using an hard drive. I don't have an SSD, and some say that even if you have a SSD, you need to make the to enable this mod because it makes the game runs better. I don't know, I didn't test it, so of course you can use this just with slow on or off if you have an SSD and see if it will help your FPS or not. So let's load the last save or the same save we used before, and let's see how much frame rate we can gain. So as you can see here, I'm getting like 38, 37. Before I was getting like 30, 31, 32. So I get like 8 to 9 FPS maybe. And I can assure you that if you have a GTX 1050 Ti, you will not drop below 30 FPS using this mod. I tested before and it didn't drop, but what makes the FPS drop a lot is my CPU. If you have a better CPU than mine, I'm having 3470. If you have an 8-thread CPU or 12-thread CPU or some Ryzen CPU, you will gain or you will have a better frame rate and a better FPS than mine here. Even visually, the game doesn't look that bad compared to the in-game low preset. It doesn't look that bad, in my opinion. So for comparison's sake, let's use the very low preset and the mod and see if it will help our frame rate more or not. So guys, right now I'm gonna use the very low preset. We will set the preset at very low, as you can see, and let's start the game and see what kind of frame rate, what kind of visual we will get. So it's the same setting as before. We'll drop this to 87 as before. 1080p gameplay, call density low, slow HDD mode is on. Let's load the same save, this one. So as you can see here, with the very low preset, we're getting like 40 here, but the visual does not look good. The very low preset disabled the TAA, and the game looks looks a lot worse than before than the low one. You can enable the TAA. I don't recommend disabling it because as you can see everything is aliasing is everywhere. The game is full of jaggies, but at least the frame rate is much more better than before, as you can see here. It's much more smoother and better. Even though my CPU is pulsed, the frame rate doesn't drop that much. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like if you did, leave a dislike if you didn't, and don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching.